Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Mega Bloks Halo set review. This one was officially released in 2012. It's set number 97189, came with 551 pieces. This is the UNSC Rockethog versus anti-aircraft gun. It apes an actual in-game campaign mission, which I appreciate very much. Comes with four minifigures. You get the Rockethog and you get this nice, pretty large Covenant AA gun installation. Figures left to right, Jump Pack Brute, Covenant Ascetic, the Elite Ascetic, Hazop Spartan, and then a Marine. None of these figures jump out at me as being especially special, but I think I like all of them about the same. The Jump Pack Brute here with the purple, main purple color, and then a lot of these printing marks that are in a dark red. I think it's done pretty well. Personally, I'm not a big fan of the Brutes, but I think that as they go, this one is well done, has a good color scheme, and even the Jump Pack itself is a little bit extra nice in that it has two colors. So most of them are a single color. This one has the purple and the gunmetal gray used together. Here's a look at the back of the Ascetic. Also a pretty well done figure with the, I appreciate the use of bright color that stands out, that lets you see the lights. The head on the Ascetic is also done pretty well. These little horns that stick out can kind of bend pretty easily, so that's something to watch out for. But you can easily bend them back. Mauler right here in gunmetal gray. Very nice plasma sword, energy sword right here. I love that color in particular. Got the old style of pea shooter, the plasma pistol. Your Hazop Spartan. The paint on this one wasn't done all that well, I think. I believe the yellow is actually paint, and it's going on top of a dark color. That's always hard to pull off. You have to put on a lot of paint. I do wish that they had used a different color for the visor for this one, just to get a little more contrast there, because that gold is a little bit close to the color of the head piece itself. But they did good with the little tubes around the side of the breathing apparatus. And then this Marine, I think, is done very well. You know, it's your standard open face Marine, and standard torso and arms for this one. Does have a wash over this one, which a lot of the time Marines do not. You got the reach style of assault rifle here, and his color scheme overall is a combination of black and gray that's all dirtied up with a wash that goes over the whole thing, just to make him look more battle worn and, you know, like he's actually been out in the battle. He's also got a pack on the back. So there you go, that takes care of your figures. The set that I got, I'm not sure if this is standard, but I also got a few extra little plasma pistols with this one, and in addition to some extra plasma grenades. So I always appreciate that. And then you get a few of these little crates, little containers, little Covenant storage and moving boxes, basically is what they are. Get three of those. This Rockethog is pretty sweet, actually. It's in a very dark green with some camo, some kind of marbling in it. Has some black, also has some, I think, tan used in there to give it some different colors. Got a lot of stickers around this one, adding a lot of detail to the appearance of it. Looks like kind of a high-end model compared to some of the others. This is a little bit more believable, and just it looks more like a model than a toy compared to other ones that they've done. Of course, you've got the working suspension. The parts did work out well for me here. You can see it's nice and loose. I appreciate the normal tinted window. It just looks a little bit more tough and believable there. And the colors go all the way up the stand to the rocket launching turret itself. And this turns around and also can be angled up and down. I think this is one of the better Warthogs that they've done, period. Just on account of the choice of color. And yeah, the choice of colors, I think, is really your top thing that they've done here that works out well. And this looks realistic enough. I like it. I'm very happy with this. I can understand why some folks would want to get this entire set just to collect this particular Warthog, because it's a really good one. The AA gun emplacement is cool. They actually used a lot of specialized pieces for this one. which is good or bad, depending upon how you want to look at it. I appreciate when not a lot of specialized pieces are used and more small pieces are put together, but by doing that, they were able to make something that was fairly large that still fit within a fairly small parts count. This actually goes together fairly quickly, all the base and everything. Most of the building work goes into the main gun section, especially this part back here. That's really where they use a lot of existing parts to create the whole structure of it. You can see it rotates around and also can change in its elevation. There's, because of the way that it's built, there are so many small pieces back here, it becomes very solid, and it's actually heavy back here, so it wants to angle itself up. You can kind of get it to stay like that, but if you just tap it a little bit, you can see that it's starting, there you go, it wants to fall down. But not really a big problem, not a major problem. I mean, it looks best facing up anyway. Lots of bright colors, looks pretty good. You can see the kind of the charging. This is a sticker back here. It makes it look like it's charging up. I like the little teeth that are inside there for the little plasma accelerator, I think is what it is. On the base, a lot of large pieces. So all of this is one piece on one side. All of this is one piece on the other, just connected in the middle. These pieces, like one piece here, snap, snap, little fascia pieces on the outside. This base right here, which has some stickers on it, that's all one piece. The base down here, the plates, 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So again, just a lot of large pieces, but it ends up looking pretty good. So I really can't complain. This is a really nice little feature inside of here. You can see the core, which has an opening to it, lets you get in there. You can see this is actually clear, so you can't shoot through there, but you can shoot through the openings, just like in the actual mission. So nice realism. It's a little bit more realism than was even needed to really pull off a good set here. And the thing just looks good, just sitting still. If you just want to have this on display, it makes for a great piece. And plenty of places to put figures. All these studs all around here. You can even have figures, especially since we have the jump pack brute. You know, it makes sense to put him up here and put some other figures up higher. So there's a lot of potential there, and I think it works out well. This is originally a $60 set. I think it was 70 bucks at Toys R Us, and you can find it for 50 on Amazon now. Kind of averages out to 60 bucks, which is the original suggested selling price. 551 pieces, you know, price per part works out okay, but then when you consider how many of the parts are very large parts and how much playability you get here overall, how much kind of presence of stuff that you get, I think that it works out to be a good value. And I really appreciate the fact that it related to something that was actually in game. It's done pretty well, and even if you take it out of the game, the, you know, just as a toy, the big AA gun looks really good. It just has really nice presence to it. I like the fact you can pose it around, though I wish that it was balanced a little bit better. And the Rockethog just looks great. That's just something that a lot of fans want to have just by itself, just the hog. And the figs are fine too. I'm not a huge fan of any of them, but I don't dislike any of them either. So I think that this worked out pretty well, and I'm happy to have gotten it. So there you go. Those are my thoughts on this set, the UNSC Rockethog versus AA gun. And I hope that you'll stick around to check out more reviews that I do as I do more, and other ones that I have done in the past. If you haven't gone through those, you can browse through them on my channel. And if you subscribe and or follow the blog at jangbrickss.com, you can see all of my latest updates and new stuff that I do as quickly as it's available. So I hope to have a chance to yak at you again soon. But for now, I'm going to go build some more stuff. So I'll talk to you later.